This is my review of the Razer Core. So when this thing first came in, I was super excited to play with it, and so I did, but a couple weeks later, I've decided that I should do the responsible thing. I ran some benchmarks, did some tests, finally made a review. Here it is. So the Core itself is extremely well made. I was hoping it would have good build quality for the $400 or $500 that it costs, and it really does. Full metal construction and very heavy. The build quality is super solid. There are some rubber feet for some grip, side, top, and bottom ventilation, but there's no airflow through the front. It's super easy to open, a handle that flips out to unlatch the mechanism, and the tray slides out. There's a thumb screw for mounting the card, and they've oriented the PCB so that when the card is installed, the release latch is on the bottom, so it's easy to remove again. The power supply is from Enhance. It's 500 watts, but as you can see from its shape, it's not a regular ATX supply. There's several intake fans on the bottom. One of them feeds the power supply, one bigger one feeds the main area, and then the last one blows into the PCB area, and there's one exhaust fan underneath the shroud for the power supply. The rest of the airflow has to come from your video card. The software setup on the Stealth is pretty easy. You install some drivers, reboot, and you're good to go. The blade needs one more step. You need to install some software to turn off the 970M inside. When it's connected to the Core, the Stealth doesn't need its charger. The Thunderbolt 3 connection will charge the laptop while you're connected, but the 14-inch blade will still need the charger. They both connect using the Thunderbolt 3 port, and the cable is very short. It's around 20 inches. It's an active Thunderbolt 3 cable, and they keep it short because longer lengths can have signal degradation, but I've tried a lot of third-party cables, none of them worked. Now, the Stealth has the connection on the left side of the laptop. The 14-inch blade has it on the right. So in terms of setting it up, you're gonna have to fiddle around with positioning and stuff, but if you plan on having the Core on one side of the monitor and your laptop on the other side, it's not gonna work. The cable's too short. The Core also lights up with Razer Chroma. You can adjust colors and timing with software again. Overall, I think they nailed the design and the build quality. Now, both of these laptops are skinned with D brand skins. The Stealth has the black titanium. The Blade has the black carbon fiber. I highly recommend putting a skin on these devices to protect the anodized finish. There's a link for them in the description below. Now, in terms of performance, I actually tested out quite a few video cards, but I'm only gonna go into detail about the 980 Ti and the 1080. Now, in general, I don't love using benchmarks for videos, but sometimes you just gotta do them. So just one other thing to keep in mind. The cards that I use in this video are reference cards. They weren't overclocked at all. There's gonna be other third-party cards that you can get better frame rates and stuff with, but these are the reference cards just for the video. So right off the bat, these are the base scores of the Razer Blade Stealth and the 2016 Razer Blade 14. We also have a current generation desktop running a 980 Ti. Next up, these are the scores when the 980 Ti is put into the Razer Core, and I'm only using the external display for output. The laptop display is turned off. And you'll also notice an Alienware score. That's the same 980 Ti running in the external Alienware graphics amp for an Alienware 15 with the same specs as the Razer Blade 14. So the 980 Ti gives a nice boost to both of the Razer laptops, particularly with the Stealth. It's not as fast as a desktop, and it's actually a little bit slower than the Alienware graphics amp, but it's a very nice boost overall. And then I also ran the same tests, but this time I did it with the built-in display of the laptop. So as I mentioned in my previous Razer Core video, you're using up bandwidth to send the rendered data back to the laptop. So the Thunderbolt 3 pipeline gets a little packed and you get a bit of a performance drop. It's not too much, but it is measurable. Now the Alienware graphics amp also has a drop in performance when you're sending it back to the display. Now I did the same tests, but this time with the new GTX 1080, and everything runs a little bit faster, but yeah, it's the same idea. So here's the deal. The video card that you put into the Core will perform at around 85 or 90% of the efficiency of a desktop setup. The exact card you want to put in obviously depends on your budget, but if you're looking to buy new, the GTX 1070 looks pretty awesome right now. And with the 980 Ti or better card in there, you'll be able to run essentially any game you want at 1080p, ultra graphics settings at 60 frames per second. Now, if there's a specific game you want to run at a specific resolution or graphic setting or frame rate, you'll have to look up your video card, but the bottom line is that you'll get around 85 to 90% of the efficiency of a desktop system. Now, many games are GPU dependent, and those will run nicely on the Stealth if you have a good video card in there, but some games are more CPU dependent. For example, Witcher 3 and the new Doom, frame rates on the quad-core Blade are noticeably better than the dual-core Stealth. To determine which games are more CPU dependent, there's really no sure fast way to tell, but something that can help. If you look at the required specs, if the minimum requirement of a game is a 4-core CPU, even if it's a super old CPU, there's a good chance it's a CPU-hungry game, but it's not gonna work like this every time. To maximize performance, notice two things. First, connect an external monitor up to your video card. Don't use the internal display if you can avoid it. Secondly, leave all the USB and Ethernet ports on the core empty. So when I tried recording gameplay footage to a drive that was connected to the core, it would occasionally hiccup. I also tried video editing in Premiere with multiple drives attached to the core. It works, but the performance gains aren't really worth the cost, in my opinion. I want to talk a little bit about the thermals and noise. So when they're running the core, both laptops run quieter, particularly the 14-inch Blade. The 970M isn't being used anymore, so the whole system just runs cooler and the fans don't have to spin as fast. The core itself has a bit of fan noise. It's very quiet and tolerable, especially at idle. When it's under load, the fan noise really depends on the card that you have inside the core. The 1080 was quieter than the 980 Ti, but in general, unless you have a really loud video card, the noise isn't too bad. I actually spent quite a lot of time trying to connect the Razer Core to other laptops with Thunderbolt 3 ports. Now, at launch, the Core only officially supports the two Razer laptops as well as the Intel Skull Canyon NUC, but I was able to get some of these connected. So the XPS 13 and 15, they can connect. I was able to play some games, but it would lose connection and hang really frequently. The new HP Spectre couldn't connect at all. The Alienware 15 actually had the best connection, maybe because it's already capable of some external graphics stuff, but it would freeze and then lose connection pretty often. The MacBook obviously won't work, that's not Thunderbolt 3. The Acer Predator also had a connection, but it was super flaky. So basically, none of them work properly right now, but my gut feeling is that at least some of them will work sometime soon. It's just a matter of drivers and BIOSes being updated. I think companies will get on that relatively soon. And once they do, I'll probably be doing an update to the series, hopefully when the new AMD cards are out. A couple other things. If you want to close the lid of the laptop, you can. Just turn off the sleep setting and it works. There weren't any thermal issues that I noticed when I had either of them running with the lid closed. If you unplug it in the middle of a game, it'll blue screen, but if you unplug it when it's idling, it'll automatically switch over to the internal video card. Both laptops passed the Steam VR tests, even with the 980 Ti, but the software needs to mature. I'm gonna save that for a future video. The last thing, don't feel pressured into getting a Razer setup just to have an external GPU. There are other Thunderbolt 3 external GPUs coming out shortly, and the Alienware graphics amp is always an option that actually has slightly better performance right now, and you can always build yourself an ITX system if you want, but I have to say, the Razer Core is awesome. It's priced a little high, and I wish the software was a little bit more mature, which it will be over time, but Razer seriously delivered on a really big promise that they made with the Core, and at this point, it actually does what they said it would do. Now, whether or not it's worth the $400 or $500, here's the thing. Razer was the first company to drop the external Thunderbolt 3 graphics unit, so they can charge whatever they want. I think it's priced a little bit higher than it should be, or could be, but if this is something that you've always wanted, I think it's worth it, at least at the $400 price point. That's the end of this video. Hope you guys liked it. Thumbs if you liked it. Subs if you loved it. It's been nice. I'll see you guys next time.